Hello there. Today, we're progressing with our exciting multi-part series on constructing AI-powered applications using FlutterFlow, Firebase, and Google AI. Remember how in the first episode, we built a basic foundational app for the later showcasing of AI concepts? Here's that FlutterFlow app, underpinned by the Firebase system and a Firestore database. Recall that we can deploy this app as either a mobile or web app, thanks to the versatility of the FlutterFlow framework. If you have your own app or are using a slightly different tech stack, you should still be able to follow along. But if you intend to follow our exact setup, we recommend watching the first episode of the series. You'll find the link in the video description. This episode promises more thrilling adventures. We're about to integrate some generative AI capabilities into our app, specifically with Google's cutting-edge Palm 2 AI system. Using this in conjunction with Cloud Functions, we will populate our Firebase collection with AI-generated text content. Here's our plan. We're going to create a destination description field in our Firestore database, which we'll populate using our generative AI workflow. Considering the various data types, we prefer this to be a string. In a blink, we have an additional field in our schema. Backed by the powerhouse Google Cloud, our Firestore database is all set. So, for our exotic travel app, each time we add new destinations, we'll automatically generate a description for that destination. If you're using LLMs for a slightly different use case, we think that you'll still find this video's concepts and architecture helpful. When using Cloud Functions, we'll need billing enabled in the Google Cloud project backing our Firebase project. Additionally, we'll typically want a service account, which is separate from the main FlutterFlow service account and which has Cloud Functions and Vertex AI permissions. We'll create that later. After enabling billing on another screen, we're moving along. There are a number of ways to have a Firebase event-driven AI workflows. But let's keep things simple and employ a first-generation cloud function triggered by Firestore, our database. We will maintain onCreate as the event type and specify a parameterized places collection. Most settings can remain at the default values, but an essential configuration to tweak is the service account. Let's create a fresh one. Meet our description generator. You can add roles right here, such as Firestore permissions. And for now, we'll just deploy the Firebase admin role. Our loyal companion on this journey will be Python. It's commonly used and allows us to reuse Google AI Python sample code. But don't worry if Python isn't your forte, just use a different language that you're more comfortable with. We'll provide the demonstrated code in the video description, so feel free to copy-paste rather than tediously typing this alongside us. In front of us now is a function comprising two crucial elements: a requirements file, our container of dependencies, and the real champ, that is, the code. This gives us a sort of draft mode for now. We're just printing our event. Let's print out the context too. We'll add the additional AI and Firebase stuff shortly. With our function up and ready, it's time to put it to the test. We'll whip up another document in Firebase. The console is our playground here. Let's keep it simple for our first test document. The logs are looking good, so onward and upward. Our aim here is to get this cloud function pumping out AI-generated content for the description value instead of depending on our explicit inputs. However, for a digestible step-by-step approach, let's next test the setup with a hard-coded description. It's time for a refresh on our source code, along with an introduction of the latest version of our Google Cloud Firestore client. We need to get our hands on our document path using the resource string. From there, we'll use the document reference to update our document. Let's hit save and redeploy, then dive back into the testing. And remember, we're all about cleanliness here. Let's wave goodbye to that old test document before creating a new one. See how fast the description was changed from bar to foobar? And our logs confirm a successful function execution. Are you ready for the next twist in the plot? It involves some AI magic for the description. Let's clear out our workspace by deleting the test and saddle up for a visit to the Vertex AI platform. Here, in the language section of the Generative AI Studio, we'll explore Google's generative AI capabilities. While we could extract some example app data to test, let's keep it simple and input something manually. Of course, we're going to be parameterizing the name of the location in our cloud functions code. If you have a more complex use case, the prompt engineering could be quite a bit more complex. However, for our purposes, this sample code should work perfectly. Moving forward, how about we take a peek at the code together? Here's a little snippet which runs the prompt for us and fetches a response. Let's give our entry point a bit of an update and merge it with the sample code. To obtain the name value from our new Firestore document, we extract it from the event. We'll make the assumption that we always have this name value when we're creating a new document. Let's customize our AI API call to use the name value and then use the response as a new description value. Finally, we'll ensure things are saved and deployed. Before we test this out, we need to do a quick little edit in the IAM and admin page. Our description generator needs a bit more permissions. Now, we're not only covering Firebase, but also Vertex AI. Back to the logs of our function. It seems our AI library hasn't been found. The culprit is our requirements.txt file, but that's a quick fix. With our deployment proving fruitful and our description generator service account bestowed with the necessary permissions it needs for both Firebase and Vertex AI, it's time to put this to the test. For our test document, let's go on a creative streak and add an interesting name. This way, we unleash a fascinating and meaningful description when the results roll in. Interestingly, we still get the foobar description update. Seems like after the deployment hiccup, the function reverted back to the initial working code. Let's jump into our Google Cloud Storage bucket, which supports our cloud function, and download the code for our failed deployment. Voila, we have our new code again, this time packed with our AI platform library installation. Fingers crossed, third time's the charm. Looks good. Our source code is updated and the function is flashing a positive status. Let's give it another whirl. And in a few heartbeats, we have this engaging description field popping up in our Places collection. Looking at our current code, you might spot an interesting quirk. Our names lack spaces. This could throw a wrench in the works for our AI model. Will it be smart enough to decipher this as Galapagos Islands? It might just be, but let's give our model a helping hand anyway by popping in the missing spaces. By making these changes, we have a convenient event to use for our AI event description generation. Let's modify the trigger here to update. And remember, if you want a trigger that covers all operations, that is creation, deletion, and updates, just adjust this event type to write. Let's redeploy our function in its fresh form. As soon as the function update is complete, let's work through our names. Of course, we could automate this if you have a much larger Firestore collection. We're almost there, folks. Sit tight as the final and most thrilling step is about to unfold, integrating our descriptions into our app. We're going to keep it simple by dropping them in as a text element under each destination name and rating. It seems we've taken a minor detour by adding our descriptions to the wrong collection schema, but no worries. Let's swiftly correct that and place it back in our places collection. Now comes the moment of truth. Let's kickstart our app and put it to the test. Although we could clean up the styles a bit more, we think you'll be excited to see that our AI-generated descriptions for all destinations are gracefully sitting on our places cards. Want these magical descriptions for new places too? Switch our cloud function back to create, and the AI will do its work, populating the description for each new place. Ideally, you have a form in your application that lets users submit new places, but we'll save that for another video. The best part? You're just using pay-as-you-go cloud functions and Vertex AI. You pay only when the function runs, so unless you're dealing with a flood of document creations, your cost for this entire system will barely make a dent. Don't hesitate to leave your questions in the comments. Thanks for tuning in, and please enjoy responsibly.